Now let's analyze direct central impact. Okay, so in direct central impact, what do we have? If this is my two bodies who are colliding and this is my line of impact, then direct central impact is going to be an impact in which your center of gravity is in the line of action and your velocity is also along the line of action. Okay, it could be like this and this, or it could be like this and this, or it could be like this and this. Okay, what we want is the velocities should be directed along this line of impact. Okay, their sense can be anything. For the time being, let's just assume that this is the scenario. Okay, their velocities are in the same direction. Okay, so what I have is something like this. Let us say this is VA, this is VB. If my VB is greater than VA, at some point I am going to have an impact. Okay, at some point this is going to meet this guy and make an impact. Okay, now let's understand what happens when we have an impact. There are basically two phases in an impact. If let's suppose these are two bodies which are in impact, what happens is in the first phase you have deformation. Okay, so if over here you have a VA and you have a VB, okay, then in the first phase what happens is these two bodies get deformed. So maybe something like this would happen. Okay, now in this phase these bodies are joined together. You can think of it like these two act as one body and they together move with a speed, let's say called as V. Okay, now this is known as your phase of deformation. Okay, so this is your phase of deformation or period of deformation. Okay, now depending upon the material of these two bodies, your deformations might go away or they might be permanent. Okay, so after the period of deformation, what happens is there is a period of restitution. In this phase these two bodies, they get away from each other and move with two separate velocities. So in the next phase what's gonna happen is, if this is my one body, this is my another body, these are going to move away from each other with separate velocities. Okay, so let's say that this is VA dash and this is VB dash. So your this impact is basically composed of two phases where you have a period of deformation when your bodies get deformed and they move together with a common velocity. Okay, then you have a period of restitution when they get separated, and depending upon your material of this body, they may remain deformed or they may regain their original shape, and they then move with two separate velocities. Okay, each having its own velocities. Okay, so now with this thing known to us that impact is considered or is composed of two different phases, we are going to analyze our direct central impact. Okay, if we just assume that there is no friction between these two bodies when they make an impact, then the forces of impact are going to be normal to the surfaces. Okay, if this is my one body, then the force on this is going to be like this. Okay, and this is my other body, then force on this is going to be like this. Okay, where this is what? This direction is your direction of your line of impact. Okay, so only forces that we have over here is along this line of action. Okay, there are no forces happening in this direction. Okay, therefore your velocities are not going to have any component in this direction after the impact.